I think the Lions might have solved their problems at, on the in the kicking game.
You think?
Yes. Brandon McManus was cut today.
From the Broncos.
Denver Broncos.
The last guy from their last Super Bowl team.
One of the best kickers out there in the NFL, really. I'd put him as a top six, top seven guy.
Absolutely.
A surprise. This is from Adam Schefter. The Broncos informed kicker Brandon McManus, the last remaining member of Denver's Super Bowl team, the man who has kicked for the team since 2014, that they are releasing him per sources. There's now an added veteran kicker for a kicker needy team. Let me paint a picture for you, okay? It's week 18. The Detroit Lions are at home, down 28-27 to the Minnesota Vikings. A division championship on the line from 52 yards away. You've got Brandon McManus or you've got some dude from the XFL. Who are you more comfortable with? Or Badgley, who's the kicker, Maz?
Yeah, Michael Badgley, Badger.
I'm more comfortable with some kicker named Brad McManus.
Yes. And you might have to pay him, what, $3 million a year? Remember Brandon, what we said about Prater, Maz?
I know.
You know, remember what you were hardcore on?
Yeah, 100%. I remember why couldn't we kick out the $6 million? It was 2 years.
Yes. It was like 3 years, up, like $7 million or something like that.
Yeah, we went through four kickers that year. Four.
And now they sucked 2 years ago, so it didn't matter.
The 3-13-1
or whatever. But now they don't suck. Now you can't be giving games away. And when we were talking to this prior to the show, Maz, one of the things that you said was they didn't believe in their kicker in Minnesota. It ultimately cost them a win, and it cost them a playoff spot. Go pay a kicker.
Here you go. Where was Matt Prater before he came to the Detroit Lions?
Denver.
Well, there you go.
I like
it. It makes sense. It's the second time around. When you kick in Denver, the altitude is nuts. It, like, mile high is mile high for a reason. I hate playing in Denver. I hate the warm-up process, but it is equally as hard. Actually, it's more for kickers. Kicking in that out there, oh, my God, it's tough. So you look at the fact that he kicking that for – he's been there 8 years now. He's been in 2014. So you're talking about, 8 years. 8 years he's kicked in that. Kicking in this dome is a piece of cake for him. You got to bring in Brandon McManus. Like, that's just a must-have.
Just a reminder, they did bring a kicker in last week from the XFL.
Yeah, send him back to the XFL.
San Antonio Brahmas. This kid's a 25-year-old kicker. He's good. John Parker Romo. Look him up. He is going to be battling with Michael Badgley. Neither one of these guys are going to make $1 million. Neither one. So are they going to go on the cheap like they have been in the past? Or will they go out and get the cagey veteran from Denver?
According to their excuse for not signing Matt Prater, technically they do believe in this team now, so they should be going after Brandon McManus.
Yeah, I just, I think about my confidence level in big moments. I'm not just talking about games. When your team sucks, when you're not expected to do anything in any particular year, with every win, every moment becomes bigger. And I just don't know. You know, it's the unknown versus the known, right? You got an unknown commodity. You got a known commodity. Who's to say that this 25-year-old from the XFL isn't the next Justin Tucker? I don't know that.
Correct.
He could be. I don't know that.
You know what you got in Badgley? Badgley is not good from 50 and above.
Michael Badgley is fine. He's a fine
from
kicker.
From inside 50, he's good.
He's a serviceable guy. But if you've got an opportunity to get a top six guy at any position, whether it's quarterback, wide receiver, kicker, offensive line, linebacker, I think you got to take an opportunity and at least look at that situation.
Agreed.
Only question I have is this. Last year, the Detroit Lions were the most aggressive team on fourth down in the NFL. Dan Campbell loves to go for it on fourth down. Dan Campbell doesn't mind pushing the envelope. Dan Campbell's also had bad kickers for the last 2 years.
Yep.
Part of that mindset is our kickers can't kick anyway, and this is a new NFL. Does that mindset change if you bring in Brandon McManus, who you know can kick the ball from 60-plus? But does that help the Lions or hurt the Lions?
I think it helps them. I think it gives them an extra weapon because you don't know what this guy's going to do now.
1,000%.
Is he going to go for it still, or are we going to kick a 60-yarder?
And that's what I agree with. There's been times where Dan Campbell has said they went for it because they didn't have that kicker.
That Minnesota game was that game.
Patriots.
Yep.
Patriots game. Go get Brandon McManus.
So
go,
Mike,
go
get him. Michael Badgley last year, 20 of 24 kicking field goals. He was 4 of 5 from 20 to 29. 6 of 6 from 30 to 39. 8 of 10 from 40 to 49-yard field goals, and 2 of 3 on 50-plus. So they didn't really attempt many 50-plus.
And I think 52 or 53 was the longest that he
53 was his long.
There you go.
When you were reading that,
that's nothing.
That sounded like you were reading a college freshman kicker stats. Like that's not going to cut it in the NFL a long time. I mean, everybody's going for it. You keep Brandon McManus.
Who signed the Michigan kicker? Who drafted him in the third round?
San Fran.
I think they know what they're doing.
And there you go. That is a great point.
Conversely, let's look at McManus last year, shall we? Anybody want to do that?
Okay, I'd love to. I don't know what kind of year he had with a bad team, but I know one game he was all the points.
So McManus, he was 28 of 36. Boy, they kicked a lot of field goals. The Lions attempted 24 field goals last year, and Denver 36.
Yeah, they had a horrible offense.
Wow. 6 of 7 from 29, 10 of 10. From 40 to 49, 8 of 13, 50-plus.
Yeah, he wasn't great last year.
He's 55. Also kicking in the mile high. Like, you're going to be kicking inside a dome for the better part of the next 10 years of your life. Like, go sign him up.
Yeah. Sean Payton got rid of him, so I don't know. We'll see.
I think he makes a difference.
You need money.
Yeah, they got Russ.
Give me Romo.
Oh, my God.
I want to see what Romo's got.
So great.